This year we're moving forward, 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 and we never turning back. So everybody know, raise up the banner, raise up the banner, woy woy, raise up the banner, raise up the banner, woy woy, raise up the banner, raise up the banner, woy woy, raise up the banner, raise up the banner. We out on the road, it's forward movement, and when we dip on the streets.
Being married for 15 years, that's as a youth, it's pretty tough. But one thing I remember when I said that word, I do, is that the pastor, which is my dad is the person who's responsible for me being married, and he was actually the pastor that married my wife and I. And one of the things he made mention is that make sure God is in the center of your marriage. And I kept that in the midst of my 399,000 faults within the 15 years. I always remember that. The other advice that I took from a very good friend is that no matter what struggles you go through, never go to sleep vexed. And because how I changed my personality from the bitter person I was, I'm a very jolly person. I like to make people laugh. So my wife and I will have the most bitterest argument, like, yo, I just annoyed with you. I just can't take you. And she will be like, yo, I can't take you. And a minute or two after, I'm not over exaggerating, because she was here, she would tell you, yo, watch me, I need to get a 5 hours to go down the road. Babes are feeling to eat this now. Oh, come on, watch this now. Well, I will do something funny, like, I don't know if I should say this, but dress cool. I might put on something funny, or I'll put on a funny walk. Oh, I will just say something to make her laugh. And she will be like, boy, I want to be vexed with you at this time. I really want to be vexed with you. I don't want to talk. But we'll just laugh it out. I remember my mom was telling my day, because we had like a real bitter argument. You realize I'm saying bitter plenty, but yeah, that is my talk. And my mom was like, yo, all I need to cool it. We're going to tell you, take the dick. And in tutus, we closed and put on, and we ready to pump, we ready to go out and have a good time. So people who know my wife and I, we really, 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 I must say, in the midst of the struggle, the Bible says, what God put together, let no man pass under. And it's real. Yeah, she is really, really a strong person, because to deal with Karen behind the scenes, I'm telling you, I am a person very difficult at times to deal with. And she have a very, very strong backbone to deal with me, you know what I mean? And I must commend her for that, you know what I mean, for the times that she spent and you know, she told me something recently. She said, the only reason I stay in here for you, Virgin, is because of God. It's because God tell me straight out, I had to stay here to see you go to the next level. And I think she said she made that commitment to God that, you know, she really stick around to see the furnace go to the next level. And it's true. Sometimes we does feel to call it quit. But we hold on because we know that the blessings is just right around the corner. When you feel like giving up, you're seeing this straight road, and you're just looking for that blessing, but you're driving, you're going along with life, and you're not seeing that blessing. People, take it from Karen Thomas, the furnace. Your blessing is just right around the corner. You know? Because when you feel like giving up, the blessings was just right a step ahead. One of the things that I learned in life too is faith. I never had faith or believe in faith that good things could happen because of my upbringing, you know, my bitterness as I mentioned. But I believe in faith now. As you see on my t-shirt, I have a big sign, Mark Favor, which is one of my songs, and I really believe in this song because the favor of God is real. Yeah, that's how that tap in. And I would just say this. God wants to bless each and every one of us. You know? God wants to bless you, you know. But it has something called alignment. So if God is above, which we know God is above, right? And he wanna pour down his blessings on you, and you like this, and you like this, and you like this, you're not in alignment, which means you can't bow off, which means you're bow-legged, that kind of vibes, you know what I mean? But if you just do so and put yourself in alignment like this, right there, God wants to bless you. So my point is, don't matter how much wrong you do in this life, don't matter how much thing, and you say, yo, I cross the limit of doing bad stuff, God could forgive you. I have reached a point in my life, I come to this conclusion, Lord, when I look at my life, and know, well, you know, your TV and your radio interview and stuff and thing, and they're like, yo, what people go see is that people who want to blast you and say, you saying this, but you live that life and whatever and thing. One person could judge you, or one person I really, really consider and business about is God. You understand? Because at the end of the day, you have to answer to God. You understand? So it doesn't matter what people say. Sometimes we allow people to steer our life, and sometimes they stay off the road, they stay in a ditch. So at the end of the day, you focus on God. Focus on God, and God will take you to the next level. And it's as real as that. Well, the name of this song is Favor. The song that really, really close to my heart, you know, take me to the next level. Yeah. Thank God for favor, me telling them favor. Thank God for favor, me telling them favor. Oh Lord is favor, oh Jesus is favor, me telling them favor, oh Lord is favor. Listen, a whole year gone, a new year come, but me thanking Father God, his grace keep me holding on. But in spite of all the things I've done, say your love towards me, Jesus, it remains strong. I thank God for favor, me telling them favor. I thank God for favor, me telling them favor. Oh Lord is favor, King Jesus is favor, me telling them favor. Oh Jesus is favor. Favor of God. Trust me, just keep on trusting. Let's have an next part of the song say, when Jesus Christ say yes, tell them can't say no. All the blessing Father have for me, man, it must come true. Right now, me not leaning. It's Christ alone me believing. So me never want to grieve him. Blessings, this is Karen Thomas, D. Furness, and you are watching Music Lounge. We will be right back.